Hi, my name is Judy L. Moore, and I'm a freelance editor with Black Wolf Editorial Services. Over the course of a variety of different videos, I've been showing you how to use Scrivener to your full advantage as a writer. Right, well today, we're going to talk you through some of the things that are unique to Mac. Now, for those who have watched the videos from the beginning, you'll know that I happen to have a Windows-based system. However, my writing partner, Ann Bell Feinstein in the States, has a Mac system, and she has graciously volunteered to help me. So what we're doing is we're actually screen sharing her computer so I can record it and we can have this conversation. Say hi, Anne.
How you doing, Judy?
Right, so what are you going to show us today? What feature that is only in Mac are you going to show us today?
All right. I recently got from a beta reader a manuscript written in rainbow colors.
Ooh, a rainbow colored manuscript. That's not a good thing. What happened?
No. Well, I don't know for sure, but I suspect they are a Scrivener user. And you have to pardon me while I'm getting rid. I hate the scene thing in the.
Okay, so you've just created a standard novel.
A brand new novel format project. Nothing to it except lose that scene because I prefer to keep chapters, not scenes.
Brilliant.
So, all right.
So what are you going to do?
Oh, as soon as I get my chapter thing active here. Hang on. It's being stubborn. All right, Scrivener expert. I see where I'm messing up.
Okay. So for those of you who didn't quite see what happened is it was clicked onto the corkboard mode, and Anne just needed to put it into a mode that she could actually type in, and that was just changing into that one file section under group mode. Okay, so what are you doing?
I'm just doing a little bit of typing.
Okay, this is my novel. Yes, he is black and white, and he's an annoying little cat sometimes. So cute, though.
All right, so now, where is revision mode? I knew we had it yesterday. There it is. All right, so what's available in Mac under the format thing? And I'm going to leave my screen just sitting like this so you can see it. I went across the top toolbar and went to format. Revision mode. All right. First revision. I'm going to click OK.
Okay.
And you notice it pops up this warning. Any text you type in the editor will use the selected revision color.
Okay.
All right. So, and I'm going to leave it so it always shows up, because we're going to see this a couple of times.
Oh, and we had a nice thing that All right. just said revision mode, even cooler. Oh, it's red! Okay, the equivalent under the Windows system, if you want red text, you can actually just put red text. But we don't have this revision mode, that's for sure. Okay.
All right.
Oh, we're writing a little short story. I love it.
Had to pick on something, and since Philip is right here, he's a convenient target.
Yes, fair enough. Okay, so what are we going to do now?
All right, so we did revision mode. Now, that was revision mode one. This is revision one. I'd help if I could type today. All right. So now we're going to go back to format, go back to revision mode, and we're going to tell it none. Now, have you ever highlighted a section of text?
Oh, yes, I do occasionally, but not a lot.
All right, so we're going to highlight that. We're going to make it yellow.
Okay.
All right, so we've got, this is my novel, My Cat's Black with White. We've got some writing here. All right. Oh, I thought I'd turned off revision mode. We're going to get out of revision mode for a minute.
Okay.
Oh, it didn't turn the text black to black. Give me 2 seconds. I don't know why it's doing this today. Of course, it didn't the last time. Last time, it conveniently went right back to black.
It did, didn't it?
And of course, it's being stubborn.
Well, why don't
Of
you
course.
try typing in a different revision color?
All right, we can do that. We'll go with revision 2.
Because I seem to remember when we tested this yesterday, you had multiple revisions.
All right, so now we're going to try this again. Revision mode, none.
It still doesn't want to go back to black. Oh, there it goes. Yes, it's back
It
in black.
probably had to do with the fact that I did the highlight first.
Okay.
All right, so you're learning a little bit about my cat while we're doing this. So, format, revision mode 3. Again, our warning about text color pops up.
Okay. Oh, that's really hard to read. Oh, ugly.
Never said I liked it, but at least not this color. I'm sure you can change it. So we're going to get back out of revision mode. All right. So we've got three different colors and a highlight going on here.
Okay.
Now the question is what's going to happen when we compile?
Okay, so what is going to happen? So if we run the compile,
All right.
and I take it you're going to choose the standard manuscript format.
And here's all the options.
Okay, so we need to
Now,
choose under formatting,
yes, it's always under
we
formatting. We
need to
need to
make
make
sure we're
sure our
teching.
text. Okay, so my text is there,
Okay,
right?
but we're going to use, instead of novel, we're going to use standard manuscript format, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so we down now need to make sure that text is there now.
There. All
Brilliant.
right. So we're going to compile right now, right?
Okay, and we're going to compile for Word, I take it, not a print.
Yes, of course. I'm going to use doc because, as we've discussed previously, sometimes hinky things happen if you're actually using a cover page, which in this case, I don't care about the cover page, but it's the fact of
Yeah,
sometimes your cover
we
page
just,
can go hinky.
yeah, DocX and Scrivener are not always a good mix. Yeah. So
All
compile.
right.
What happens?
Compile. Let's see. Revision mode. I'm going to call this Philip. Why not? And normally, like you, I would save it somewhere, in a folder with my project, blah, blah, blah. But I'm just going to save it on my desktop so we can find it qu real quick.
Yeah.
All right, and it's thinking. That's what the little color wheel means in Mac. We're thinking. It's the Mac equivalent of the Windows hourglass.
Oh, okay.
For anybody that's not familiar. All right, so we should have our document. Now I already have Word open with a blank document, just so I'd have it open. Open. And we're going to go to my desktop. And there's Philip.
Okay, we're opening.
We're thinking, hey, this is the I think I can. All right, so we have our cover sheet and we have a rainbow manuscript. Now, this may be
This was the
helpful.
standard manuscript format.
Yes, now this may be helpful if you're trying to track your own revisions, but I don't think you want to send it this way to a beta reader, to an agent, or an editor. Am I right?
You
want
no,
to write?
no, no. Oh, no. So how do we fix that?
All right, we're going back to Scrivener, and I did Command Tab, which is the Mac equivalent of Alt Tab in Windows,
Okay.
just to go back. All right, so we go back to our compile. Obviously, we missed something.
Yeah. Just something. Right. So
Right,
it's not under
under
formatting.
transformations,
Okay, under transformations.
there's these lovely
Oh.
remove text color, remove highlighting.
Yeah, we have those under Windows as well. So if anybody is using highlighting or text colors in their manuscripts for Windows, you might want to know that this exists. It's in exactly the same point and place as well under compile transformations. So now that we've got this selected, what
We're
happens?
all right, we're going to compile again, but we're going to call this one Philip 2.
Okay.
And we can put it just right on my desktop again, just for convenience in this video. That way I can find it real quick without digging through 50,000 files.
Always a good thing.
Well, at least when we're recording. All right, so we're going to go back to Word. Remember, here's Philip the first one, right? File, open, desktop. There's Philip 2. All right, that looked the same. Guess what?
Oh, much nicer. Okay. So, lesson learned. If anybody is using the revision mode under Mac, you might want to make sure that you are removing all highlighting and all text color from your compile because it could be nothing worse than sending out your manuscript to a publisher or an agent with highlighting and funky colors all the way through it. Yeah, not a
Because
good
remember,
look.
here's what it looked like before we told it to get rid of all the colors.
Yeah, not a good look. Okay.
And that was the new one.
Brilliant. Fantastic. I think we've learned that. This is just a feature that's on the Mac only. However, under Windows, we do have the ability to add highlights and add colors using the format buttons. We don't have revision mode, but we also have the ability to remove all highlighting and remove all colors while we're compiling. So it's just something to keep in mind. Thank you very much, Anne, for showing us that. And I hope everybody learns this lesson. And we'll see you
Because you
next
want your
time.
text to look like that.
Yeah, we want our text to look like that. Definitely. Right. We'll
Not
see you
this.
next time.
All right, take care, Judy.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.